At Britomart Reef, around 100 kilometres north of Townsville, the water was crystal clear.
It was the middle of the day, it was our last dive.
But not for long.
A cloud of blood kind of enveloped me.
The hunter becoming the hunted.
It happened so fast, the shark must have been doing 100 miles an hour. It bit me twice.
By the time Rick Batua reached shore, he was barely alive.
I wasn't breathing, I was unresponsive.
It took 14 bags of blood, enough to fill an entire body, to save him. 15 months later, Rick is still missing a chunk of his leg.
Rick has been our test pilot.
Rick's a guinea pig for a new kind of wetsuit called Shark Stop.
It's a high-tech polymer. They use the same material to make tow ropes for pulling ships.
Developed by Northern New South Wales local Hayden Burford and tested by Flinders University on sharks off South Australia's Neptune Islands. Their bites barely penetrated the fabric.
So the size of the hole would basically put a puncture in your skin. You might bleed a little bit, but you would not suffer the horrendous tearing and ripping.
Rick is performing his own less scientific test, putting other skills he learnt in the US Navy to use. This is a regular wetsuit, and this, Hayden's Shark Stop suit.
As you can see, there's no holes.
Not only does the material resist a bite, it's painful for the shark.
When they bite the fabric, their serrations catch on the fibres, so it's pulling on their gums and they just want to let go and go away.
The material used to make the suit costs 7 times more than the normal synthetic rubber. Hayden's wetsuits will sell for around $900.
It is an expensive product to make, but what's your leg or your arm worth?
Because I didn't have a Shark Stop suit on, I almost lost my life.
The suits will be on sale from tomorrow. Alex Lewis, 7 News.